Hi, I'm Jordan Roberts, TruVision Entertainment. We are here with Paris Barclay. Paris, who has won 2 Emmy Awards, one for The West Wing, the other for NYPD Blue. And he has been wonderful enough to be the moderator at the panel here at the DGA for 25 years of gay storytelling. I see you're wearing a baseball cap.
I am.
And I understand that you have a baseball cap collection.
I do. I have probably 200. But that's not that many, really, if you think about it.
Is it all just sports, or is it everything?
No, this is DGA, okay. I think. I have Outfest through the various years. Uh-huh. I have every show that I've worked on that produces a baseball cap. So and a lot of caps people give me.
Every show you've worked on, so that's not more like 500?
No. I've only worked on about 80 shows.
I'm just teasing you. So, you know, I read a while ago that you had something in development. A cop show, and it was going to be called Hate. Mm-hmm. It was about hate crimes and NYPD Blue. Are you still...
No, we created a pilot for that show called Hate, starring Marcia Gay Harden, and it was produced for Showtime, and they decided not to go forward with it. They went with Brotherhood instead. Mm-hmm. So that show that nobody's watching is the show that they had instead of our incredibly brilliant show that was about the Hate Crimes Division of the New York Police Department. I might bring it back in another guise, but...
Did you write it, too?
I was co-writing it and directing it, and it was produced by Bruce Cohen and Dan Jinks, who are also Outfest supporters and originally conned me into coming to Outfest, actually.
What can we do to raise awareness about hate crimes, and also how can we prevent them in the future?
Well, in my little business, I don't know how we can prevent them, really. What I've been trying to do, and I'm going to keep doing it until I succeed, is try to produce some kind of ongoing television show like what we did with Hate that sort of, you know, wraps it in entertainment but also really talks about the political implications as well as the sociological implications of hate crimes. And there'll be stories every week that people can get involved with, but really what I want to do it for political purpose. I want to help create an environment for change for our laws, and I've seen television do that throughout history. I mean, there's a book called Rape and Television, which talks about how the rape laws were changed because of Cagney and Lacey and L.A. Law, and those shows actually doing stories about rape have actually helped to propel people towards a greater consciousness and less looking at women as victims, and I kind of want to do the same thing. It feels like it has to be many, many hours over many years to do the job it needs to do, which is why I'm still committed to figuring out some kind of basically television show vehicle that can deal just with that issue.
I love that about you. You know, Judith Light said in an interview...
My hero.
Isn't she wonderful?
Mm-hmm, wonderful.
She said, celebrity can be hollow unless you do something with it.
It's a big waste. I mean, you can have a nice house, but if you're not going to use it for whatever is really important to you, so what?
Gosh, we should get her to be in one of your things. Get her attached to it.
I had hoped that she would be the star of Hate, but I didn't get the network's approval.
She's wonderful, yeah.
She was actually my first choice.
We don't have full marriage equality. That's another thing that I'm also hoping that filmmakers will start to make projects about.
That is so funny, because that's the last thing I said in the panel that we just had of filmmakers, which is, you know, I just gently suggested that we may be behind the curve in telling stories about gay marriage, about gay families, because we haven't been exposing people to that in the media. They're more surprised when they hear about it, like it's new to them. And I think just the way an early Frost sort of helped people learn about AIDS, and later on Gloria Rubin's character in ER paved the way for a different understanding and thinking about how minorities and AIDS were interacting. I think we have to do the same thing in the media with marriage and with gay families. We just need to portray them in every kind of comfortable situation so that people go, oh, okay, and they get used to it and they bring it into their homes and it's less of a, you know, a threatening kind of thing. So that's our job. We're not really doing it yet.
Not yet.
No.
Is there a parallel between the no biracial marriage and no gay marriage?
Well, I think there is, but obviously certain civil rights leaders don't think there is. They think it's a very different thing, but I see it very clearly as just another act of discrimination, and eventually it'll fall just like biracial marriage did.
Yes, I was just talking to Jane Anderson about different rights that we don't have in terms of burial and in terms of our lovers seeing him in the hospital. She's talking about getting power of attorney until these laws can go into effect.
And more people have done that. I know I certainly have done that with my partner. We've got wills and trusts and powers of attorney that'll give him all the legal standing that the law can currently allow. Marriage would be a lot easier, but we'll see.
Yes. Well, thank you so much, Paris.
Thank you. I appreciate it.